The other day I was messing around with a little riff from Howlin' Wolf's famous blues song, Smokestack Lightning. As a child, I loved this song, heard it on the radio, and I was just completely captivated by it. There's a great film of him appearing in London in 1964 with this really sort of straight English announcer bringing him on stage, and he kind of comes on with his great looming presence, his amazing physical presence with his guitar. He puts his guitar down, starts chugging away on his mouth harp, and the band joins in, and it's just absolutely brilliant. I'm sure I must have seen that bit of film when I was a child, and it deeply impressed me. And I'm not really a blues man, as you may know, but you know, some of it I do really love. And so I thought, just for fun, I'd mess around and get the riff from Smokestack Lightning on this one string guitar. Obviously it's not ideal for playing the whole song. I did try singing it and playing harmonica at the same time, but I binned both of those ideas and just stuck with playing the guitar. And if you've seen the other video, you know I used a bit of black and white effect on it, and you know, just messing around for fun. Hope I didn't offend any of the blues purists with it. You know, I was just having fun with it. So I'm using this one string guitar. Notice I've got a capo behind the first fret. It's actually tuned to C, this string, but with a capo behind the first fret, the open string is now D. I've got a diatonic neck, dulcimer type neck if you like. And so I'm doing this in a sort of D Dorian mode. So the scale I'm going to use is, scale, typical D Dorian, sort of a D minor scale, and I'm using my little Roland Cube Street EX amp, which is actually a pretty good amp. It will do 50 watts and it runs on 8 AA batteries. I've had it for a couple of months and I thoroughly recommend it. If you want something to take out which you don't have to plug in, it's brilliant. And as you can hear, I hope you can hear that, I'm using a bit of reverb and a very short slap back rock and roll echo, rock and roll delay, which works really well on this, I think. So for the main riff, I played D and F, and I sang doo doo. I sang D and C. So the effect, the overall effect was doo doo, doo doo. So I was making a chord with my voice and with the guitar. That sort of worked pretty well, I think. So running up on the guitar, running down with the voice to provide that chord. One of the reasons for putting the capo on the, or behind the first fret, so I keep returning to that D, and if I didn't have the capo there, I'd have to keep fretting it with my fingers, so it's handy to have that as the open note. And of course I don't play anything lower than that note, so it's, that works really well. That's the reason for putting the capo on there. So when I play this, I'm playing fret 9 up to fret 11. Okay? And I'm singing the equivalent of fret 9 coming down to fret 8. Do, 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 like that. Now I'm going to do this nice little slur up. It's fret 4. I'm actually saying the proper frets, not the capoed fret. So, okay, essentially it's fret 3 now, the capo on, but I'm going to call it by its actual name, fret 4. And I'm going to slur, like a real dugout slur. Hear the note I'm slurring from and the one I'm slurring to. So the notes I've got here are G, A, C. Finger 1 to do that slur, and the little finger falls nicely for that C note. And then, so slur back, down to the F, and then open D. So that's the opening and main riff, if you like. Okay, and if you sing with it, do, 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 do. Okay, and with a little bit of slap back echo there, I think that sounds pretty nice. I've got quite a thick string on this guitar, give it a bit of meat. You know, if you use a thin string, I don't think it'd sound as good. So that was the Smokestack Lightning riff, and I just added a few bits like this. D, F, which is obviously an octave below that first bit. And it's fret 1, which is capoed, of course, and fret 3. A bit of vibrato on the F, a bit of a bend maybe. Just those two notes. And what I like to do halfway through this is I like to do a bit of palm muting. I bring my palm over the bridge, and that really brings out the delay, doesn't it? A bit of strumming on the string sounds good. I'll do this hammer on then, F up to an A note. It's fret 3 to fret 5. Okay, and then ending up with fret 1, or if you want to call it open. It's a bit confusing, I know, the capo, but I'm sure you get the idea. So that bit, without the palm muting to start with, maybe play close to the bridge, get a kind of thin sound. And then with the palm muting, Smokestack Lightning is just something I've added, a sort of generic blues riff, if you like. And then I do this kind of almost bass rundown. Okay, so I'm going D, and then C, and then B, A, G, F, E, D. Again, if you do the palm muting there, I think that sounds pretty good. So the fret you've got to miss out is that one there, because that's obviously not part of your scale. And I'm in conversation with Table Edit, which is a software program for doing tablature. And I'm trying to get them to produce some effective tablature for these type of instruments, because they've got a dulcimer tablature that doesn't have that extra, what they sometimes call the 6.5 fret. So I'm in conversation with them, and hopefully when they come up with what I need, I'll be able to do these things in tab for you. That's basically it. I'll just play it through once for you. Just a bit of fun there. Actually, I did try and sing it. It's actually really hard to sing and play, and to add in the harmonica riff at the same time. These sort of things look really easy. When you go and try and do them, they're pretty hard. So I really sort of take my hat off to anybody who can do that. Something I'm going to work on a bit with the old harmonica in the harness. But anyway, I hope you enjoyed that, and I'll see you in the next video.